pastor's wife. She's a Sunday school teacher. She has two beautiful daughters who are married to gorgeous men, of course. And I could go on and on and on, but most of all, she is a godly woman. And I want you to make Sister Burnett Brown welcome.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Haven't you sensed a settling down of the Holy Spirit here?
Yes, amen.
I thank Him for that. I've had such a great time this weekend. I think we brought the most from my home church, Beach Fork, in the history of this. And I took a little nap last night. That's what I'll call it, because I didn't get much sleep. I feel like I'm feeding back. Am I really out? Okay. So, but I asked the Lord to touch my body. That's much better. I asked the Lord to touch my body so that I wouldn't, you know, like be very tired this morning, and I feel really good. I'm anxious to get what God laid on my heart off of me and into you. It came to me, the scripture that He laid on my heart came very fast and furious. And once I get into the lesson, I will call it, I may start teaching fast and furious. And I, when I'm preparing for these, I do battle with the enemy.
Yeah.
Because the enemy tells me over and over, and I'm not going to talk much about myself, because that's not the lesson today, it's not the message, but he tells me over and over, you don't fit in with Tammy Jones, she just has it all together. And I may look like I've got it together for a minute, but once I open my mouth in a few minutes, you're going to be like, what happened? But, yeah. Sandy and her beautiful family, I'm like, Tom, I'm not family. How come they keep asking me back? And he says this. He just like puts it out there. He said, hun, Sandy knows exactly what you are. He says, she knows exactly what you are. You just have to go and give them what the Lord gave you. So is it okay if I do that today? I'm just going to give you what the Lord gave me. And I am a school teacher, and the last days of school, I'm more babysitting teenagers because we've already done all the work that can be done for their minds for the year. But they made me up some posters, and I have a PowerPoint I'm going to use also. But I need a couple of ladies to help me. And you don't have to do any tricks. It's not minute to win it. But I need you to come up here, have a seat on these chairs, and just carry a sign when I ask you to across the stage. Do I have two lovely women who will help me out with this before I get started? I really appreciate it. Do I have another one? Okay, thank you. So, and if you could move up your chairs a little closer, and if I get wild, just, it'll, Holy Spirit will protect you. And who's up there? Young man? Is there a young man up there? Okay. So I'm used to having a clicker, so I might just be like, if I want to go to the next slide. So let's hit it. Go to the next slide. Enough about me. So when I was going down, the Lord had already given me my scripture. I was going down the highway, and I'm like, Lord, what am I going to do with this scripture? And bam, 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 He gave me this. I didn't get it out of book. He gave me this. He said, I want you to make an acronym out of that word, hope. It is a word, but I want to use phrases in that so that would stick in their head. So you can write it down, or maybe you don't need to write it down, but there's probably something in here for you, or God wouldn't have sent it. I like to read books. I still read all kinds of books. And when I am purchasing a book, I go right to the table of contents, and I look at the chapter titles. And I see if they will interest me. So the chapter title for today is hope. I don't know what your chapter before this day was, it might be called grief, it might be called disappointment, but whatever it is, we need to get to the next chapter, and that is hope. Because God has a plan. I need you, sissy. I think I'm going to have you stand up a lot today. Okay? And when I give you the cue, I don't know what it'll be, then I want you to just take a stroll, because I want these ladies, take a stroll. Am I scaring you yet? Okay. Would you take a stroll? Because throughout Israel's history, regardless of where they got themselves into, regardless of what God allowed to happen, he always had a plan.
Amen.
In this story today, the plan's name was Samuel. I don't know if God's plan has a name. I don't know if it's a person. I don't know if it's a place. I don't know if it's a new thing, but he has got a plan.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But there are some obstacles to overcome. The presence of God and the power of God must return, because I'm going to tell you, I know I'm getting scary. You're like, where did that little woman go? The Holy Spirit has showed up. You prayed about it, God's got a plan. Take another walk. I'm going to walk her. Yes, young man, we'll go to the next one. Now you're in the battle of your life. And so he has a plan, but before we can get to that plan, we've got some obstacles to overcome. Let's go forward. What's your name, young man? I'd like to be able to call you by name. Justin? Justin, thank you. Justin, let's go on, because I sometimes get ahead of myself, so I'm going to go on. Let's go on, Justin. There we go. We have some obstacles that we've got to overcome. There are some of you in here today. God witnessed to my heart when he told me what he wanted me to speak about. I'm like, I just don't know about this. And he said, trust me. I'm like, okay. Once I got here and I heard the rest of the speakers, I knew God definitely had a plan. But before you can get to where God needs you to be, you're going to have to give him some of your obstacles, which is disappointment, grief, bitterness, unbelief, discouragement, depression, hopelessness. I've not lost a husband. I've not lost a child. I can identify with what some of you are going through right now, nor will I attempt to minimalize what you're going through. I will not do that, but I'm telling you where I've been. I have been in a bed of depression. I really thought it was my last chapter of my life. I really thought I was going down for the last time. I almost drowned when I was a young teenager, and I remember my friend in the pool. I couldn't swim well. I got in too deep over my head. I panicked. I couldn't swim. I couldn't even dog paddle. She got me by my shirt, and she threw me up on the side of the pool, and I lay there until I could get my breath. When God brought me out, Psalm 40, I think it is verse 2 says, he brought me out of a horrible pit. He established my glory. He put a new song in my heart. This is what was the outcome.
She would text me and say, today we
have. Look at what an effect he will have. We were out of town on a Friday night, and Jenny called me, and she said, Burnett, hospice is here. Jen's took a turn for the worse. Before we could get there on Saturday morning, Jen died. I was upset. I was not in agreement with God over this. I had prayed. I had worshiped. I had went to church. But there was something between me and my Savior, and it was pure disappointment. And you know what the enemy said to me? He said, it's not that God chose not to do it. Your God's not able to do it. I'm just going to ask you to be brave. Has he ever told you that and you believed it for a split second? It's not, can we get real? It's not that God won't do it. He can do it. And I'm like, so God, here we are on my knees. I'm repenting. And in my heart, I'm like, God, I mean, God rolled back the memory curtain for me. He began to remind me of all the miracles he had done. He began to remind me of all the prayers that he had already answered. And he said, do you believe in me to keep telling women all over this area that they can have hope? I'm like, yes, sir, I do. I got up off my knees. The presence of the Lord returned.
Amen.
It filled my study. I had a good old time in the Lord, but I had to apologize to God. You may have to apologize to God for not being in agreement how he's worked things out in your life. And I know it's not fair, but when God has another plan, we can argue with our husbands, we can argue with our children, but we cannot argue with God.
Right.
Have you ever been disappointed in God's decision? Raise your hand if you have. God's not going to strike us. He knows your heart already. Raise your hand again. You've been disappointed. Look at that. Look at these innocent, I mean these honest and innocent hearts. God, we reverence you today. Not an ounce of us is far being disrespectful, but we're just saying reverently sometimes you just are getting over. Let's go on to the next point because it's about to get good. Let's keep on going, Justin. Oh my. I'm going to read you this scripture now. Oh, it's going to get good here in a minute. Turn to your lady and say, it's about to get good. Yep. It's about to get good. So the enemy, things weren't working out too good for them, and they're like, we're giving the ark back. And they laid the ark of the Lord upon the carts and the kine or the cattle, took the straight way. You know what that means? I don't know. I am a farm girl from way back, and I've had to drive cattle before. Have you ever had to try to get cattle back in where they belong? They do not go in the straight line. But on that day, it says the cattle took the straight way to the way of Beth-Shemesh and went along the highway, lowing as they went, turned not aside to the right. I want you to So my friend Jennifer, yes, we married Jim Gray, but I gotta tell you something. She texted me the other day. Jim had told her, put the house up for sale. They moved to their current location for him. He said, you don't wanna live here, put it up for sale. Tom said to me, my husband, he said, Brenna's gonna be hard for her to sell that double wide. Hard to get a loan on the double wide. Tom's just a practical minded man. I'm like, well, we just gotta pray about it. Jenny had that house on the market one day. Hallelujah. And I was having it out with the Lord in a respectful way. He said, if you will just trust me, I am going to show you soon how I'm turning Jenny's life around. She's out house hunting today. I sent her a scripture this morning to encourage her. And she sent me back some hearts. And Jenny's still grieving. And she's going to go through that process for a while. But God has a plan. And while she's going through the process, God is going to leave her many handfuls of purpose.
Yes.
All right, Justin, baby, let's keep it rolling. Now, 1 Samuel 7. Samuel spake unto all the house of Israel. This is very important. Samuel spake unto all the house of Israel, saying, if you do return unto the Lord with all your hearts, put away the strange gods. You know what the strange gods in your lives are? Disappointments. Not moving on because you think God can't. That's a strange god. He said, if you'll prepare your hearts unto the Lord, serve him only, he will then deliver you out of the hands of the Philistines. Then the children of Israel did put away Balaam and Asherah. Disappointment, hurt, bitterness, regret, unbelief, hopelessness, and serve the Lord only. Keep it rolling. Then this was the day when everything turned around. They gathered together the Mishpah. They drew water. So they drew the water, and then they poured it out before the Lord. And they fasted on that day. The children of Israel said to Samuel, cease not to cry unto the Lord our God for us. Keep praying, Samuel. Keep praying, because we need it, that he will save us out of the hand of the Philistines. So what this was saying was, they're still afraid, but they're doing it anyway. Look to the lady next to you and say, you might be afraid, but trust God anyway. We were afraid, but trust God anyway. Keep it rolling, honey. And as Samuel was offering up the burnt offering, the Philistines drew near to battle against Israel. Woo! This is my favorite verse of the whole day. But the Lord thundered with a great thunder on that day on the Philistines and discomfited them. And they were smitten before Israel. Keep it rolling. Discomfited means, in Hebrew, hamam. And that means to crush, to break, to destroy. So I'm here today to send you this message. What tried to crush you and destroy you and break you, God says, I'm going to do a turnaround. We're going to crush, destroy the enemy. And I was looking at this verse. Just stay there, honey. I was looking at this verse and this hamam. And I thought, that kind of sounds like, hey, ma'am. In Brené Brown version. So, I want you to look to the lady beside of you and say, hey, ma'am, she's about to tell you a story. So here it is, hey, ma'am. There are times of divorce. I prayed specifically on two different occasions that God would not allow divorce to happen. One was in my immediate family. Most of you know that. They got divorced anyway. But you know what? Hey, man. God still destroyed the enemy's plan because a year and a half later, those two people, my nephew and Bethany Bear Witt, renewed their covenant. She called me on a Friday evening. She said, Burnett, are you sitting down? Get ready for this. I'm like, I am. She said, with your permission, we would like to exchange our wedding vows and renew our covenant next week in your house. I'm like, what kind of place do you want? What's your colors? I'm like, Tom Brown, let's get the house decorated for Christmas. We're having a party. Now, right here in front of my grandparents, maybe need a covenant. My marriage is better than ever. Recently, we had a young couple in our church that was struggling. I knew some things going on. Divorce papers were already delivered. Guess what? They ripped them up. She posts all the time. I love my husband. I love my family. Recently, she posted a picture of all four of their hands, and they were all cleaning together. God is back first place in their life. Yeah. You say, Brennan, it's too late for me. I'm telling you, God's not done with you yet. There's a next chapter in your life, and it's called hope. What are you going to do about it? Are you going to keep kept coming across to me. They need to seal the deal. Samuel took a stone, set it between Mizpah and Shin, called the name of an Ebenezer, saying, hitherto have the Lord helped us. You know, last year it was this. This year, you know what we need to do? We're setting up a stone. Anybody need to do this and give God an offering today? You need to take this sign from me. Take a walk again, girls. Just take a little walk. Haven't they been good? Take a walk back and forth. You got it. He's got a plan. Everything's going to turn around. Anybody want to take this sign from me right now? You want that chapter right now in your life? Hope, I feel like an auctioneer right now. Anybody going once? Going twice? Hope, anybody need hope in their life? Hallelujah. Come and get her, sister. Don't be afraid. Come and get her. Rip it up and share it. Now, you can do whatever you want with it. Hey, sister, here's what I want you to do. Sissy, what's your name? Blondie. Hey, come here. I always wanted blonde hair. Not going to happen. Anyway, I want you to take this sign. And who else needs a little piece of this sign? I want you to go. Now, you got to know something about me. I'm not always this bold, am I, Sandy? And I do like to keep my hair in place, so you know. But when the Holy Spirit is on me, I get very bold. What I want you to do, I have this vision. I have this vision of a person leading the sign around this auditorium and everybody else who needed hope following her and taking a mark, a victory march. Would that be appropriate, Sandy? Now, who's supposed to sing? Tammy?
If I can have Angie.
Angie? Angie, where you at? Angie?
No.
So, I told you it's going to be fast and furious. The Holy Spirit came. He has sealed his end of the deal. And now it's time for you to lead differently than what you came. I'm not telling you that you're going to go home and all your problems. That empty house is going to be filled with angels. I'm not telling you that. I'm telling you, you're taking home a new hope. Here's what I tell my friend Jenny. Jenny, keep looking for it. She's house hunting today. I'm like, keep looking for it. God's got you the perfect little home out there. Girls, I know that God has a plan, and you need to grab a hold of it. Maybe you need to kneel and pray with all the workers. And maybe you just need to take a victory march and seal the deal. Any way you want it, I'm done. Because the Holy Spirit has dismissed me. And I am going to turn it over to Sandy. Sandy, come up here. Didn't these wonderful girls do a wonderful job? Before we change the order of the service, I want to make sure I give them a little gift for their trouble. And you're finished whenever you feel like you're finished. There's just a little something for your trouble. But I know the presence of God. I'm telling you, Sandy's very good to her workers. She's already compensated me for being up here. But you can pay me enough money to do what I just done, unless the Holy Spirit showed up. Boy, did he either. It's an out-of-body experience, dear Lord. This is not the Burnett Brown that you know. I turn into another being, and I'll take it any day of the week. Hallelujah. Today. And Lord, I'm sense enough to know that there are women hurting. Probably every row has many women in it that are hurting. And they need your touch today. And now, Lord, would you settle down? Now that you've lifted that somewhat off of me, settle down and get real sweet with them and cuddle up to them and whisper into their scared ears, I'm going to take care of you. You can trust me and help them to turn it over to you today. I'm giving this to you, Lord. You've blessed it. You've sanctified it. You've set it apart for your glory. The work is done, God, as far as the scripture, and now it's between you and them. Let your will be done.
I want everyone to stand. I want